Okay, got it.
Got what? Got what? Alexa, who am I? God, I did it again!
This guy's so ignorant he doesn't even know how to make a GIF. One of the oldest file formats on the internet, by the way, pronounced GIF, was formed in 1987.
I thought it was GIF.
That's only if you like peanut butter. Because I'm no GIF lord, but like I got a trick or two up my sleeve. How to make an awesome GIF. There's a couple ways, and we're gonna go through all of them.
I can't even rate how excited I am right now.
About a week ago in the mail.
Okay.
We got a package.
Okay. I like packages.
From Google. It's for your home.
It's for your home.
Noah, why do you always hide stuff from me, Carmichael? This does not look like a Google thing.
So this is how you make GIFs, right?
This is how Sam makes GIFs. If you're just making a GIF from like a YouTube video, it's actually super, super, super easy. In fact, this is the easiest way to do it because all you need to do is just go to Imgur. You take your favorite YouTube video, copy the URL, go to Imgur, hit video to GIF, paste your link in there, and the dang website does half the work for you. Once you have your video in there, you can just kind of click through and find a moment. You can choose the duration of your GIF and all that stuff. There we go. That's a good GIF right there. Clicking create GIF, and then literally just converts the dang YouTube video into a GIF. And it's not technically a GIF right now when you're watching it. They actually convert it to this really cool streaming video format. It's really cool and complicated, whatever, blah, 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 blah. You get your GIF, and you can share it, you can use the link, you can paste it around the place. Want to save it or you need to upload, you can go down to the download button right there.
Okay.
You click it, and then it will convert this into an actual usable little GIF that you can now upload anywhere you want. You say, what's happening? I say, add a photo or video. Right there. I made a GIF and I didn't even use Photoshop or anything. However, you can directly drag a video into Photoshop. Photoshop is not just for photos anymore, it's for videos too now. I've literally put the video in Photoshop. I'm gonna try and see if I can find a really cool moment. And then cut there. I've trimmed my little spot here. I'm just gonna delete all the stuff I'm not using here, resulting in just the part I want. Since we're in Photoshop, meme text. So you put your meme text over here like this. Trump, no. Let's crop this in a little bit too. We can use the crop tool here to just make this a little more efficient. Here is our little GIF in Photoshop. We've got our custom text. We've done custom reframing, the best GIF ever. All we gotta do is get it out of Photoshop. So Control Shift Alt S. If you're on a Mac, you buy a PC.
What a pro move there, buddy.
This is why I like this old Save for Web thing. This export feature allows you to get really custom with your GIF settings. Once you open Save for Web, you wanna just select one of the GIF presets. Generally, what the estimated file size is gonna be, pretty small. There's one last thing you wanna do is the bottom here of your Save for Web window, there's an animation tab. And you're gonna make sure your looping options is set to forever, so that way it does not stop looping. Sam's new gif.gif. We're about to come full circle here, Carmichael. There's two ways to upload it. One, you can go through Giphy, GIPHY.com. Giphy's kinda nice. It keeps your GIF an actual true GIF. Or you can go back to imgur.com. All right, here we go.
Yo, you can?
Oh my God, I'm discovering these things.
What the heck? It's like Photoshop on the internet.
Is it? Yeah, I guess it is. Hey, that's how you make GIFs. Farewell. Just give it your best shot.
My best shot.
Imagine everyone's cheering you on. Imagine. No, just let them imagine. Don't actually cheer them on.
Now that we know how to make a GIF, we want you to make a Sam and Nico GIF. Basically,
we want you guys to pick out some of the coolest moments you've seen from the Sam and Nico videos this year and send them to us because we want to see what moments you guys like and also we want to share them.
Yep.
If you have one or have an idea, pick one out and send it to gifts@corridor-digital.com.
Or you can actually tweet it at us real quick because once you actually upload it to Twitter, it's forever in the Twitter database. So if you just search Corridor or anything like that on Twitter, you can use it. Anyone can use it. Check that out.
That's what I said though, isn't it?
You literally you said a question. You're like, we want you to send us gifts?
No, I said what you just said.
No, you You didn't even say a fraction of that. Are you having a moment?
Let's go to Porter right now, actually. Let's go eat lunch.
Let's go.
Why you do this?
I've never actually seen one of these in person. I've watched a fair number of videos on the internet, and it doesn't seem to be a clear winner over Alexa. Alexa being the Amazon Echo, which I have at home and I've had for over a year and adore. This is Google's answer to that. I think the future is absolutely AI-controlled home assistants, and the big deal about this one is actually conversational features, so you can actually ask a question, and then without having to set a context for your next question, you can just continue asking them. Something you cannot do on the Amazon Echo.
Or Siri.
Or Siri. Siri is the worst. Yeah. Wow, it's a lot smaller than I...
It looks like a scented candle.
It does, right?
What is this?
This is the Amazon Home. But like Google Home, it's essentially a assistant. If you... If you've never used one of these things, you're in for a big treat.
Like, hey, Sherry, push my 3 o'clock.
You can control all your lights with this. I have all my lights at my apartment at home.
One of the future robots.
Yeah. Bleep bloop.
Welcome to Google Home. To get started, download the Google Home app on a phone or tablet.
What was that sound? Oh, it's because there's a freaking touchpad up top. It should be playing a test sound. World's easiest password to crack. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Okay, Google. What's 1 + 1?
The answer is 2.
How do I turn up the volume on it? It worked!
Okay, Google. What is Corridor Digital?
Sorry, I don't know how to help with that yet.
Okay, Google, who won the election?
Donald Trump won the presidency, right now. To read more, look for the link in your Google Home app.
Well, that's fine.
Alexa. Okay, Google. Alexa. God dang it, I did it again. Okay, Google, repeat after me. Carmichael is not very good at this whole Google thing.
And Red needs to go back to work.
Carmichael is not very good at this whole Google thing and ready to go back to work.
Okay, Google, play Stone Ocean.
Playing Stone Ocean on YouTube.
Stone Ocean, Arabian Nights.
Playing Stone Ocean, Arabian Nights on YouTube.
It's great. I think it has absolutely the future of home stuff.
What's your favorite part of Back to the Future?
Sorry, I'm not-
Tell me all about Marion Ebel.
Sorry, I don't know-
I'm having a lot of strikes here. What year did the movie come out?
Back to the Future was released in the United States of America on July 3rd, directed by Robert Zemeckis.
Okay, Google, what other things has he directed?
Sorry, I don't know how to help with that yet.
Stumped him. So the conversation feature isn't quite as robust as I was led to believe. Maybe I'm just not asking proper questions. What is the cube root of 3?
Cube root 3 is 1.442.
Alexa, what's that times 28 divided by 4 times the triple integral of 4x to the third?
You said Alexa.
No! No! For like the fourth or fifth time today! You knew it too. Okay, Google, you're a nerd.
Nerds have more fun.
Okay, Google, from now on, call me the ultimate master of the universe.
You'd like me to call you the ultimate master of the universe. Is that right?
No.
Yes.
Okay, got it.
Got what? Got what? Alexa, who am I? God, I did it again!
So racist against AI?
Apparently.
Yep.
Something I never expected. I'm an AI racist, apparently.
Hey, Google.
That's definitely easier to say than okay, Google.
Hey, Google, play the loudest thing you know.
All right, the loudest, Silence by Maurice Moore. Here it is on YouTube.
I don't think there's a word for what that is.
I
Actually, there is a word for that. It's love.
If you're looking for the word that means caring about someone beyond all rationality and wanting them to have everything they want, no matter how much it destroys you, it's love. And when you love someone, you don't stop, ever. Even when people roll their eyes or call you crazy, even then, especially then, you don't give up. Because if I could give up, if I could just, you know, take the whole world's advice and move on and find someone else, that wouldn't be love. That would be some other disposable thing that is not worth fighting for.
And that's how we're supposed to feel about America?
Too soon, man.